In this video, we'll talk about cash-on-cash returns and why it matters in real estate. And we'll go over the top 10 locations for Airbnb cash-on-cash returns in 2022. What does cash-on-cash return mean in real estate? Cash-on-cash return is one of several metrics investors use to determine a property's profitability. It's used to measure a property's annual return relative to the money initially invested. It's calculated by dividing the investment property's pre-tax cash inflows by the investor's cash amount invested. Cash-on-cash return essentially tells investors how much money is earned back annually from an out-of-pocket investment. What makes for a good cash-on-cash return for real estate investors? While the cash-on-cash return is affected by different factors depending on the property's location, most experts agree anywhere between 8 and 12% makes a property a worthwhile investment. However, properties like that are often difficult to come by. Therefore, some argue that getting at least 3% cash-on-cash return is already acceptable in most markets. As this video is the first of a top locations series, I thought it would be helpful to go through how we analyze a property on the Mashvisor platform and talk about why the data provided is significant. Then in the following sections of this video, we will list the physical locations by rank. So in this video, you'll hear me talking about the following terms. Median property price. Median means the middle number of a wide-ranging set of data. So in real estate, a median property price is right in the middle of all the prices in the market. Half of the homes for sale are listed below the median property price, and half are listed above that number. This is helpful to have when analyzing potential investments because it gives you a perspective of the real estate market itself. Suppose you're looking at a building, and the price is significantly above or below that median value. In that case, it's an indication that something is off with the property you're considering, and you should investigate why that price differs so greatly before purchasing. Average price per square foot. This is calculated by dividing the price of a home by its square footage. It's used to compare recently sold comparable properties, meaning homes of similar size, shape, style, and attribute to a subject property. Average price per square foot gives great context of how the property stacks up with others in the area. For example, the average price per square foot is, say, if it's 200, but your price per square foot is 450, you know that your home is probably overvalued by using this number. Days on market. Days on market is the number of days between the listing date of a property and its sale date. A short DOM often corresponds with an active and in-demand real estate environment, and a longer DOM may indicate that there were more homes for sale than there were interested home buyers, or it could mean that the property is overpriced. Number of Airbnb rental listings. This indicates the number of short-term rentals that are noted as active on Airbnb. Daily Airbnb rental income. This number is the average Airbnb rental income per day in a specific market. Airbnb occupancy rate. The occupancy rate gives investors an idea of the ratio of property booking potential, usually measured in our case in a month. The higher the rate, the more potential bookings a property may have. Monthly Airbnb rental income. This is the average monthly Airbnb rental income in a specific location. It gives investors an idea of how much he or she can earn if the rental property is on a platform like Airbnb. Of course, we spoke of Airbnb cash on cash return earlier, and walk score. This helps determine how convenient a location is to access goods and services without one having a car. The higher score, the more convenient it is to do those errands on foot, which is, of course, great for tourism. So let's recap so far. Cash-on-cash return is used to measure a property's annual return relative to the money initially invested. It's calculated by dividing the investment property's pre-tax cash inflows by the investor's amount originally invested. A cash-on-cash return of 8% to 12% is ideal but rare. Anything above 3% is usually acceptable. Last, we went over some of the metrics we use at Mashvisor to analyze short-term rentals. This included median property price, average price per square foot, days on market, number of Airbnb rental listings, daily Airbnb rental income, occupancy rate, monthly rental income, cash on cash return, and walk score.
As a real estate investor, it used to take me 3 months of research to find a property worth investing in. Then I found Mashvisor, a platform that helps investors make confident decisions within minutes. Start your free trial at Mashvisor.com.
Now, let's go over the top 10 locations for Airbnb cash-on-cash return in 2022. Number 10, Temecula, California. So what's the draw for this area? The city of Temecula is known as a tourist and resort destination that attracts over 4 million visitors annually. In addition to golfing and fishing, wine tours, there's a famous balloon and wine festival that happens yearly. This is on our list due to its rental income of over $7,000, which is slightly more than many others on our countdown today, and an Airbnb daily rate of $446. Number 9, Niagara Falls, New York. Of course, Niagara Falls is one of the 7 natural wonders of the world, and it attracts millions every year to come see it. Although everyone thinks visiting the falls is seasonal because it's New York and it gets cold, it's actually a year-round attraction. The falls are really beautiful in the winter. In the analysis, you will notice the lower median property price and higher cash-on-cash return than many other destinations that will be mentioned today. This piques the interest of many investors as it holds more manageable entry points to the real estate market, while probably thanks to the Niagara Falls, it still provides a healthy return of profit. It also has a high walking score of 80, so that's helpful to visitors as well. Number 8, Groton, Connecticut. What's the draw for Groton? Groton is on the water. It has rich maritime history and is the home of one of the final battles, the final battle of the American Revolution. So all those things bring people to the area every year and is a great place for a short-term rental. What brought this town to our top 10 list, amongst other things, is the 654 days on the market. That is an incredibly long time and should warrant further investigation, but it could indicate a great buying opportunity for investors. Number 7, East Stroudsburg, Pennsylvania. East Stroudsburg is home to the oldest state park in Pennsylvania, and it, of course, holds great hiking, waterfalls, and scenery as a result. This town boasts a strong rental rate of $290 and has a 98% occupancy rate, so definitely check it out. Number 6, Galena, Illinois. Galena is a small town in northwest Illinois known for its well-preserved 19th century buildings like the 1826 Dowling House. Also to the north of the town is a really popular place for canoeing and fishing. In analysis, it holds a high walk score for visitors and a solid Airbnb daily rate of $268. Cash-on-cash return of 7.21%. Number 5, Toby Hanna, Pennsylvania. This is a hidden gem of the Pocono Mountains. There's a lot to do here for families, water parks, theme parks, and a lot of great tourism draws. It holds a 92% occupancy rate and a 7.29 cash-on-cash. So that sounds good. Number 4, Mountain View, Arizona. Mountain View is known for its outdoor recreation, and in Arizona it's always warm. I don't know what that's like, but it must be nice. The town holds days on market of 73 and a slightly elevated cash-on-cash return of 7.37%. Number 3, Geneva, Ohio. Geneva, Ohio is popular due to the water sports one can enjoy on Lake Erie. Despite having a reputation for affluence, it has relatively low barriers to entry for investors, with median property prices at $181,000. This mixed with a high number of average days on the market, it could mean buying opportunities for savvy investors. Number 2, Gaylord, Michigan. This place was named one of the top 10 most beautiful small towns in America. It's known as a prime tourist destination for travelers in the winter, but it's really been nicely developed into a year-round attraction with a lot of nature and things to do in warmer weather also. This area has a high daily rate of 232 and a high walk score of 81. And number one, Fairbanks, Alaska. According to one report, 320 million visitors came to Fairbanks in a single summer, and it totaled nearly $125 million in direct expenditures to the local economy. With the median property price being reasonable, high days on market, and moderate occupation rates, Alaska tops our list. Thanks for watching. If you like this content, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. We post videos on real estate and real estate investing every Monday and Thursday. Also, to learn more about Mashvisor and how we help beginning investors make smart investment decisions, check out the site by clicking on the links in the description.